this today. It's a Sunday. We came in to give kind of our preview idea about the team, starting with my team, the Pittsburgh Steelers.
World champions, no doubt.
You know, this team pretty much comes back intact. On defense, Lawrence Timmons takes the place of Larry Foote, who went back home to finish out his career in Detroit for the Lions. Good luck with him on that. You got James Harrison on the end, still coming hard. You got Polamalu back there. You got Ike Taylor holding down the corner. Hopefully this year he can hold on to some of those picks and good defensive plays and breakups he makes. You got William Gay, who's going to be part of the mix. I don't know if he's going to beat out Deshae Townsend as a starter, but he's going to take over for Brian McFadden, who bounced and went over to Arizona. So the defense, what's up?
Lyman Sweet, Simon.
Oh, yeah, well, Lyman Sweet just made a play. We're watching a replay over here on the NFL Network. Check him out.
I think this is him.
This is him. But, you know, they kind of kept it on Roethlisberger on the replay. Oh, here you go, Don. Nice catch with the hands, you know, brought it in, looked it in all the way. No looking at the scoreboard this time
around. Man, E-Man said he was going to step up this year.
Yeah, so, and hopefully, our boy Eric Jackson from Fourth and Long, he played college ball with Swede. We're going to holler at him and see if we can get him to, you know, let us talk to Swede. You know, another good catch by Swede.
Oh, snap.
So, hopefully we'll get that, but that's way down the line. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Back to what I was saying, though, the defense is pretty much intact. William Gay takes over and comes in place of Brian McFadden. And I think he's going to be a good surprise on defense. So, defensively, it's going to be the same strong, hard Steelers. If anything, you watch these preseason games, I would try and check out the backup linebackers because usually that's where the Steelers get down. They kind of do it like college style. They got their starters and their stars in place, and they groom those backups.
Right, right.
That come in place and do their thing. I mean, we
start them off with special teams.
Right.
Little packages every now and then, see how they perform.
Yeah. I mean, you know, when it was Kevin Green, Jason Gilden was behind him.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? When Gilden stepped up, behind him was Porter.
Right.
You know, then on the other side, you know, you had Clark Hagans. You know, behind Clark Hagans was James Harrison.
Right.
So they always, you know, and make sure that they got a linebacker behind that linebacker
Right. That's
ready to lock and load.
And it's probably to counteract the free agency because you may lose a player.
Yeah.
You know, with Steelers, I mean, maybe just now starting to pay some players every now and then, but basically, you know.
And it's time to make big money.
Yeah.
Fine.
You know, but I mean, can't be mad at that because that's why you guys keep consistency as far as the players and the performance on the field. So,
no doubt.
Go ahead, man. I'm sorry to interrupt you.
No, that's cool. On the offensive side, Nate Washington, one of the receivers, big play downfield, stretch the field receivers, he's gone. So you're looking at Hines Ward, Santonio Holmes, and the aforementioned lineman Sweet. We're looking for him to step up. There's a few other receivers out there that's doing their thing. You know, I'm not getting to catch these games like I want to, but it's number 17. I think that's Mike Wallace. You know, or was that the guy from 60 Minutes?
I think Mike Wallace is the guy from 60 Minutes.
His name is Wallace. Mike something. But, you know, it's Wallace. His name is Wallace. I don't know his first name.
But Mike Wallace is 60 Minutes, too.
Yeah, so, but all I'm saying is that cat is looking pretty good, number 17. You got Heath Miller is still getting down at tight end. You know, the offense is looking pretty solid. It's just one of those guys got to step up as that third receiver. You know,
go ahead. Let me ask you this.
What's up?
We talk about offense. Talk is that your line may be a little bit weaker this year. What do you have to say about that?
I'm praying at offensive line because they kept pretty much the same offensive line intact.
Right.
You know, I think it's maybe one new guy up there. And they got a cat, Kiamatu. He's a hog. He's pretty good. They got
68, right?
Yeah. They got Trey Essex. You know, not so bad. I don't know why they blocked so poorly. You know, and my thought was because they were getting away from what they did, which was running the ball. Now they got them blocking. And Roethlisberger being kind of a playmaker, kind of a, you know, sandlot cat. Like,
no.
He holds the ball a little longer.
Right.
It's that sandlot style.
Yeah.
You know, which is like, are you not open? Do anything. Get open. You know, you tend to, you know, maybe give up more sacks with that kind of play.
Also, when you got linemen that are more, I guess, the culture of the Pittsburgh Steelers is running.
Yeah.
So you got linemen that are used to firing out and really just like pancaking or smashing on somebody, really getting into them. And now you guys do the little spread offense and, you know, somewhat of a run and shoot. And like you said, Roethlisberger hold the ball and sandlot ball. It's kind of hard to stay on somebody.
Your footwork has to be a lot better. You got to dance a little more.
A little more agile.
Yeah, yeah.
Less hostile.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, hopefully they'll get through and find their way offensively on that line and be a stronger line, because you're going to get that boy killed over time taking hits like that.
You don't want to do that.
Nah. In the backfield, you got Rashard Mendenhall. You got Fast Willie Parker. And you got Mwelde Moore. You got Davis, who plays fullback, but I think he can kind of run the ball too. And they got another cat, Stephon Logan. He's looking good as far as the kick return is. Logan cat. Mwelde Moore.
Logan run.
Yeah, that's a good one. Logan run.
I like that.
But y'all, yeah, you got to be over 35 to really know what that was about.
Actually, if you're over 30, you're dead.
Yeah, if you're in Logan's run, for real. But the cat, Logan, is looking good on kick return and punt return. Mwelde Moore is a good third down out the backfield, catch the ball back. But here's where it's going to get tricky. Willie Parker is, you know, kind of an injury problem lately.
Yeah.
But he's still Willie Parker. If you give him room, you give him a crease, he's going to do what he do because he's got that speed.
Right.
Now, Rashard Mendenhall comes back. Now, last year, you know, he got Ray Lewis ended his season. And he doesn't look bad, but what I will say is what I see from preseason, I wouldn't be thinking of making him no starter. He kind of looks, and anyone who's a Jet fan can maybe comment on this, or an AFC East fan.
Or if you're a Raider fan,
he kind of looks a little Lamont Jordan-ish. You know what I'm saying? And I ain't no diss on Lamont Jordan from my end.
I'm dissing you, homie.
But he does run with that kind of size where it's like you sized up, but you turning to take these hits. You ain't delivering the hit. You kind of, you know, getting ready to take the impact of a hit. Well, I'd rather see you smash like you were smashing the cop.
Lamont Jordan looked like he should be baby Earl Campbell. Instead, he just makes me want to Earl.
And man, that's good. I like to play on words.
Yeah.
But when Lamont Jordan was a backup, he ran the rock pretty well. It was when they made him a starter, he didn't look so hot. And that's the way I'm kind of feeling about Mendenhall right now. Not saying he don't run hard. Not saying he's not capable. Just saying the games and the plays I catch, that's what I kind of get. Now, maybe it's just his body size and I'm wrong, but time will tell. Hines Ward is looking like Hines Ward. He gets open and he makes catches. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, there you go right there. Making a money catch, moving the chains. So I look at overall, if this team can get past Roethlisberger, you know, and his whatever's going on, and the Achilles thing doesn't seem to be a big situation anymore. If they can get past that, stay focused, let last year be last year, you want it, but it's over now, this is a new season. We're going to be right there, we're going to smash everybody in the AFC North like we did last year, and the big test will be the first game of the season, Thursday, September 10th.
It's the 10th, right?
September 10th. September 10th, Thursday. Against the Titans, they deserve an ass kicking for that bullshit they tried to pull on us. You know what I'm saying? Stomping on the towel like they did something.
Well, there it is.
So, you know, Steelers look solid is the bottom line. It's just new starters have to step up and do their thing. Now, that's, you know, that's kind of what I want to see, but, you know, not, you know, more of that. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, anyway, Steelers look good. Any Steeler fans out there, hit it up. Let me know what you think. If I miss a few people, Ziggy Hood, he's looking solid, making some sacks, making some plays. I think it's all going to fit in.
Check it out. Hit the Facebook, man. Check us out.
Nice,
you know what I'm saying? Hit the Facebook, hit the MySpace, and definitely comment on the YouTube site.
Comment.
Chop shop, baby.
Chopper shopper. Peace.
Word up.